It's still best of nine in this round, and it's Ali Carter to start. Joe Johnson is alongside me this afternoon. And Joe, well, it was a struggle for Ronnie O'Sullivan last night, but the main thing from his point of view is he's still here.
Yes, I suppose that is the main point of view. As regards Tom Ford, he was very disappointed at missing the blue in the middle pocket, among other balls that he missed along the way, of course, but it was the blue that finally cost him the match. And Ronnie can count himself very fortunate to be playing in this quarter-final. And he's playing a man who, again, is not afraid of Ronnie. Played him a few times. And it was his safety play yesterday that let Ronnie O'Sullivan down, I felt. And once again, his opening safety shot, cannon into a red, then the blue, and he's left an early chance for Ali Carter.
Well, the last of their six meetings was in the China Open last season. It was a close match. It was in the last 16 in Beijing, and O'Sullivan came through 5-4. Ali Carter yet to beat Ronnie O'Sullivan in six meetings. But had a good win in the first round against Nigel Bond, always tough to beat. Carter came through that one 5-3.
Yes, always gives Ronnie a tough game. Well, that was a chance, albeit it wasn't easy, had to play with side. But he's left Ronnie O'Sullivan with a possible chance into the left middle. Fairly strong to get the right side of the blue, and Ronnie, as always, will want to be freeing that black as soon as possible. And that looks like the ideal opportunity, just to leave the white ball where the red is.
Seven.
How quickly his brain works. Drops into gear straight away.
14.
Yes, there's lots of players that play like this in practice and see the game quickly in practice. But when all the pressure's 15. On, Ronnie still sees it that way. Immediately playing for the correct ball, that gets him onto the black.
We
saw O'Sullivan, of course, a couple of weeks ago in Aberdeen in the final of the Grand Prix. Lost out there to Marco Fu, 9-6. Still looking for his first ranking title since the 2005 Irish Masters. That was in the Republic of Ireland in Dublin. But he made the point last night in his press conference that he has won other tournaments, not least the Masters at Wembley. And he's always the favourite in every 30. Tournament with the bookies.
And there you just got a glimpse of the grip of Ronnie O'Sullivan. Opens his fingers. Just as he delivers the cue. And then a closed grip just as he plays the shot. When he's got the cue ball just off straight on the black,
46.
He can put the cue ball more or less anywhere he wants, and really Ronnie was spoiled for choice there on which red to play for. Had the choice of 4 or 5. And just over on that slightly, making the positional side of the shot just a little bit more difficult. And attempted to catch the reds just slightly thicker than that, and now 54. Left himself an awkward one, middle distance, stun run through. Well, no problem. He looks in good shape this afternoon to me. Cueing very well. 12. Just a touch of right hand side on to miss the red 62. By the cushion. And again, not playing straight onto the black. Leaving the angle so I can negotiate the white ball anywhere.
Great start this from Ronnie O'Sullivan, and he's just a red away now from making this opening frame safe.
71.
There it is.
Yes, you wouldn't bet against him knocking in the century. 1st shot. Not bad, is it?
Well, he was let off the hook last night by Tom Ford, and maybe
79.
The reprieved man syndrome is coming into play. He looks very relaxed out there.
Well, it did start off like this with 85. Tom Ford. He knocked in a big break to win the first frame. Tom Ford duly won the next three.
86. Well, the highest break so far is 142. Now, O'Sullivan still has 51 remaining. 93. Here, so he can beat that. I'm going to 144.
94.
Yes, we'll need blacks with the remaining two reds. And there's a century.
It's not a bad way to start, is it? Century break in the opening frame.
Yes, opening shot. Well, no, he had one bad safety shot previous to that, didn't he?
Well, we'll let him off that, because he's done the business since. That's his first century of the tournament. It's 15th of the season. He's taking a pink now, as you see. So, a possible 143 on if he takes the black off the last red.
Well, that's interesting.
No, and he didn't pop the red anyway, but a break of 108 is a fine start from Ronnie O'Sullivan. So, he had a struggle last night, but has made a good start this afternoon. Ronnie O'Sullivan takes the opening frame then against Ali Carter. He needs 4 more for a place in the quarterfinals of the Northern Ireland Trophy. Ronnie O'Sullivan to get frame 2 underway after that fine start to the match. That 108 in the opening frame has given him the lead against Ali Carter. And for those of you who follow the stats, I can tell you that was his 494th century, O'Sullivan. But Stephen Hendry is still over 200 ahead in first place, 708. O'Sullivan is second, and John Higgins in third place on 365. So O'Sullivan not far off the 500 mark now, just 6 to go.
Carter electing to play safe. But that was a chance at the red.
One.
And he may have wished he'd have taken that red on now.
Eight. Nine.
Well, got too much reaction on the white ball, took it too close to the corner pocket. Intended to come round the two angles. But is it a problem? Is it a problem?
16.
And if he's on the red behind the yellow, well, he isn't. Still has this long red.
16, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Well, that all went wrong, so Ali Carter then comes to the table with a chance to put some points together.
Yes, did have a chance, but was rather straight, and he had to force the white ball out for the black. Tried to pinch a little on the pocket, but it looks like he's got away with it at first glance.
Whoa.
The red passed the blue, Ronnie duly knocked it in. Clean as a whistle.
Six. Seven.
Now, will he go into the pack, open the balls up, and have the red over the left corner? Was there any doubt?
14.
And could elect to go into them again. There is a red just above the black to the right of it. Perfect.
22.
Yeah, you have to say already, it's looking like 2-0 after the way he played in the first frame.
Yes, David, you see Ronnie O'Sullivan in this type of form with reds open, and you just don't visualise him missing.
30.
It doesn't look like he's going to miss.
31.
Oh, just didn't get hold of that white ball. Wanted to be straighter on the pink.
Thank you. 37.
And now I'm back in ideal position.
38.
And left that one short. Let's get the other side of the blue. And play to be straighter on this red.
43.
And this is a thin cut back into the left corner.
44.
Made it look easy. So 60 points in front. Brown would be 64, so just one more red. And a colour.
This
is superb stuff, isn't it?
Certainly is. Ali Carter is yet to pot a ball in this match. Did have a chance earlier on in the frame, 56. But missed the initial red, and this has been Ronnie O'Sullivan's response.
And this is why millions of people are hooked to the game. When they see it played like this.
64.
And this is looking increasingly like the second century.
65.
On the bounce.
65. Well, he's had a checkered career as Ronnie O'Sullivan, on and off the 71. Table, but nobody would doubt his extraordinary talent. 72.
And
just as the angle to stun over for the red.
80.
About that, everything to perfection.
87. 88.
And has to play the hard way up for the yellow. Could have played just up the table. Just to make it hard for himself.
100.
There's the century, two and two frames.
104.
Absolutely wonderful stuff.
Wow. 109. 115.
Yes, virtuoso stuff so far from Ronnie O'Sullivan. A break of 108 in the first frame. And a break of 122 in the second frame. So Ali Carter is yet to pot a ball in this match. Ronnie O'Sullivan leads by 2-0. Ronnie O'Sullivan it is to get frame 4 underway. Now leading Ali Carter 2-1. Stephen Hendry lost the opening frame to Sean Murphy. He's lost the second frame as well, so Murphy going well there. 2-0. He leads the 7-times world champion.
A good safety shot. Found the right line. Well, Ronnie may have left a possible chance into the back corner pocket. even the right middle.
One.
Nicely played. One. Right in the heart. Just overdone that somewhat.
Six.
It's okay. Would like to be playing for the red next to the black, to the left of the black. That would really open the game up. Yes, just felt that Ali played for the wrong red, the shot previously. Had he played down for the red to the left of the black, he may have still been going now. So it's just a safety shot.
Brown ball.
I don't think he's played a particularly good one. I think Ronnie can get to this red over the left corner. Pot. Super confident, played for the blue as well. No intention of playing a shot to nothing. And that's the tight bridge. Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Six.
And this time Ronnie can drop in behind the black. Just needed a bit more pace in the white ball. And immediately playing for that red to the left of the black.
40.
And this will open the game up completely for Ronnie O'Sullivan.
15.
really got hold of that one. In fact, got hold of it too much. Played for the loose red at the left of the pack.
23.
But now in prime position and can play for any red he likes.
Well,
O'Sullivan's timing has been immaculate today, and that's hardly surprising because he's just signed a big deal with a Chinese watch company. He was in China last week undertaking a promotional tour and shooting some adverts. Very lucrative deal, and it just shows A, how popular he is, and B, how popular the game is over in China. That's where he last played, Ali Carter, last season in Beijing. That went the distance, all nine frames. But O'Sullivan clearly has the edge so far today. He was saying yesterday, O'Sullivan, that he enjoyed going to China so much he was thinking of buying a house there, and bearing in mind the way the circuit is expanding, more and more tournaments possibly cropping up there. There's already two ranking events in China. That may not be a bad idea, because he'll have to do quite a bit of travelling.
53.
Where's the red going? Well, it's called getting them ready.
58.
Yes, no sudden movements, please.
Wonder if he'll let the house out when it's not there, David. I'm free most of the season now. 59. Well, that was difficult to get the white ball out, but look at where it's landed. And he'll take that one.
So this black will put him 53 ahead with 51 on. Looking like 3-1.
66.
Could be another century.
67.
He's already had two in the match.
73 74 81 82
Well, after that trip to China, he was saying he didn't have much time to practice, but as you can see, he's playing very well today.
87.
Left-handed on the yellow.
89.
And right-handed on the green. Always helps when you can switch around like that.
92.
Yes, I wonder which hand now. Wonderful to watch.
96.
Yes, this blue now is all it requires for a third century.
101.
There it is.
Well, a great performance this from Ronnie O'Sullivan. Three centuries in the three frames he's won. And he's not even going to bother with the black. 107 was the third of them. And it gives him a 3-1 interval lead over Ali Carter, who now has it all to do. He's going to have to leave the arena for the interval, and he'll be back, and we'll be back very shortly.
And those three frame victories have all been with centuries. A 108, a 122, and a 107. Ali had a 50 for his part, which helped him to take frame three. But here we are then at the start of frame five of a possible nine. This for a place in the quarterfinals.
Bad break-off shot there from Ali Carter, and into the blue. It gave Ronnie an immediate chance for, at a red, and what a shot that is to get over for the black.
Yes, three centuries already for Ronnie out of the first four frames of this match. A remarkable performance. He was lucky in some ways to eventually overcome Tom Ford from 4-2 behind. That's the second time that he's found himself two behind with only three to play against Tom Ford. It happened as Ronnie splits the reds. It happened, of course, in the round robins up in Aberdeen, and he eventually beat Tom, and he did it again to him yesterday. But it was a far from convincing performance, it has to be said, from Ronnie.
Well, this is a totally different Ronnie O'Sullivan today. He's put that one to bed and decided to come out the way we know that he is.
No.
When he plays at the top of his game, there's no one better.
Well, certainly he's blitzed Ali so far. Of course, he's never lost a match to Ali. They've met six times previously, and all six matches have gone to Ronnie.
17. 24.
On your left, to play on the red,
32
to the middle,
33.
Oh, great shot. Need some angle on this black. I think he's got some. And it's coming directly back off the side cushion here. And again, perfectly played.
Lots of cue power there.
40.
It's got a wonderful touch, hasn't it?
Oh, when he's on the song, Mike, as you say, there's nobody finer to watch. Switching to left-handed. It doesn't often make much of a difference. Although he is stretching here, even left-handed, it's still a stretch.
Just wonder if he might play on the single red or attempt to nudge them here. I suggest that they go into them. Got a good angle. Oh, great shot. Got away from them slightly, but he's okay. Still got this red to the left corner. And also one, well, a couple to the right corner, but the left one is favoured. Ah, just think it might. The unwritten rule.
Well, I think we've reached the stage. Let's just watch, see if he gets this red. There you go. And look through the gap. He's on the black. And if he gets this black, that's seven reds and seven blacks. Well, this would be extraordinary. Three centuries already. We're not really thinking in terms of 147 here, are we? I bet he is, you know.
Well, I think if he makes a century, I think there's only four players in existence that have made four centuries in five frames, the best of a nine. Best of nine match.
Seven.
Just a little bit short with that one. I mean, he's already had three already, as we mentioned. This would be incredible. Four frames won, four centuries.
Yes, the last man to do it was Sean Murphy.
With a possible maximum.
Well, that hasn't been done. Most definitely not. But with this fella, anything is possible, Mike. You just never know.
He was a couple of balls away from going out of the tournament last evening. Tom Ford missed that blue to the middle.
72.
What a difference a day makes. Well, this is on. He knows the frame is won. He knows he's going to be 4-1 the lead. He'll be now thinking about the maximum.
And equaling the record of 4 centuries in a best of 9.
Well, Fergal O'Brien. Oh, hang on. Oh, he hasn't played that very well. I was about to say, Fergal O'Brien at the top of the list with that 1-4-2. £2,000 for the high break, £20,000 bonus for the maximum. He's still got the red to the middle, though. Back for the black. Well played. It's still on. He'll be definitely thinking about it now. Went for the cannon, and he's played it well.
He's second in the all-time list of maximum makers, in official tournaments, that is. Stephen Hendry has had 8. Ronnie is second in the list with 6. Although he did have one, actually, in the summer, in the Kilkenny Masters, but that was not ratified as an official 147. The table was a local table, as opposed to the match tables that they use for the ranking tournaments, and so that doesn't count. But this is becoming increasingly likely now. Blue in a slightly awkward position, not on its spot, down in the balk area.
Well, this is awesome.
Isn't that incredible? 4 centuries in 5 frames we've seen in this match. Unbelievable stuff. And they've all come from this fella. This is a totally different Ronnie O'Sullivan from the Ronnie O'Sullivan we saw just yesterday against Tom Ford. Although he won, he was very shaky at times, nearly lost his self-control in the seventh frame when he was 4-2 behind.
112.
But this is just absolutely awesome stuff from Ronnie.
113.
And he's got an angle to come off the top cushion and down for the yellow. Fifteen reds, 15 blacks, 6 colours to go.
Oh, he's perfectly on the yellow as well. Well, he plays this left-handed. He has a bit of pressure on. Left-handed. Doesn't care, does he? Unbelievable.
122.
Oh, okay, just a little bit short on the green. We'll have to come off the side cushion for the brown. This has been immaculate.
Well, there's a £20,000 bonus. Oh, look, he's going all the way to the cushion.
Well, it's absolutely flown off that cushion.
I was just going to say, Mike, £20,000 the bonus for a 147 on top of the £2,000 high break prize. What a shot he's got here, though.
This is a toughie. This is a toughie.
Oh.
What can you say?
We all held our breath for him there.
Well, it was unfortunate that the white flew off the cushion like it did from the green, but what a shot that is to recover.
134.
Well, it deserves the £20,000 for that shot alone.
This is unbelievable stuff. Unbelievable stuff. 4 centuries, including a maximum.
Well, just the black to confirm that 147. Fergal O'Brien will be not best pleased. He had a hand on the £2,000 high break, but this shot for £22,000, and there it is! A 147 from Ronnie, the 7th official maximum of his career. 4 centuries, including a maximum, in the first 5 frames of this match. That is a new record, in as much as he's the only one to have had 4 centuries in a best of 9, including a maximum. What a performance from Ronnie O'Sullivan. And the total break time at just 8 minutes and 2 seconds. In the context of the match, he leads 4-1.
In from defeat then, as he was before the last frame, trailing 4-1. He managed to win the 6th, despite those 4 centuries from Ronnie O'Sullivan, including a maximum in the 5th frame. Yeah.
couldn't see enough of the red to pot it. So just a containing safety shot.
Just briefly to tell you, there is other snooker going on as well. Ding Junhui leads Steve McGuire 2-1. Stephen Hendry's trailing, though, to Sean Murphy. Murphy leads there 3-1.
And that was a careless shot by Ali Carter. Freed the black, but left the red on to the right centre. And that was just careless. Wanted to push the red past the middle pocket. I think that's the first ball he's missed. And you couldn't call it an easy shot, could you? Tight under the black cushion. Playing the red into these tight middle pockets. But miss it he did, and he's left this chance for Ali Carter. Now, where's the red going? And this certainly is a chance for Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Whoa.
Well, there goes the maximum.
Well, he would have had to split the prize with himself anyway, so one's enough.
Only joking.
Second.
Of course, the match is his first concern.
Seven.
I can tell you, if he were to make another century, that would be snooker history, to win
40.
Best of nine frame match with five centuries. No one's done that before.
Well, if this red goes in, the balls will be all over the place. And he could have done with a bit more angle on this black. It's a tricky black, this now. And look at that. Stunned the 22. White ball through that gap of reds. I can't say I've ever seen Ronnie O'Sullivan cueing as well as this.
Yeah, this is about as good as it gets. It's been a real entertaining display. And he will want to kill off the match, I'm sure, with another century.
Yes, you can bet your life he's trying for this record of five centuries now. And I, for one, I'm sorry about this, Ali Carter, but I, for one, hope that we're watching history here. In the making.
41 42 49,
and just come a little too far on these two reds. So up for the blue.
Forty-five. 55.
And once again, playing for two reds.
56.
Now, will he take this opportunity to go into the reds? Could still play for the loose one.
63.
And rightfully so, trying to win the match first before concentrating on the century.
64.
So just this blue.
That should be 5-2.
69. 70.
And that's the pack of reds open now. Can he get on a colour to get back down to these reds? Looks to be a little straight on the yellow.
80.
Well, a power run through, left-handed. What about that for a shot?
72.
Incredible.
This has been some exhibition of snooker.
73.
Remember someone once compared Ronnie O'Sullivan to Al Pacino in The Godfather. They reckon he looked like him, but today he's reminding me more of another film star, Michael Caine, because he came to get Carter.
80.
That's what he's done, and he's done it in some style. Now, can he get a fifth century?
81.
Can't see any reason why not now, Joe.
We're just going to ask you for a bet there, David, if you wanted a bet against it.
89.
Don't think I will.
Well, this is incredible snooker. Absolutely incredible. Five centuries.
Yes, no one's ever done it in a best of nine frame match. This is snooker history. If this blue goes in, there it is, five centuries from Ronnie O'Sullivan. It simply does not get better than this, I can assure you.
Quite amazing.
He's potted them right-handed, he's potted them left-handed. He made a 147, remember, in the fifth frame.
I just hope he's got this on video.
111.
Or maybe I don't. I could sell him it then. But this has been absolutely fantastic.
Yes, you can't teach genius. You're born with it. Ronnie O'Sullivan is a great natural talent. He's worked at his game as well. And it's all come together today.
I'm so pleased for him. Such a nice fella.
122.
And such a great genius.
Yeah, breaks of 108, 122, 107, a 147. He finishes off with a 129. Ronnie O'Sullivan creates snooker history. Five centuries in the five frames he won. He's through to the quarterfinals of the Northern Ireland Trophy. He's put on a show for this crowd at the Waterfront Hall in Belfast. Ronnie O'Sullivan, in superb fashion, has beaten Ali Carter, and he's beaten him in some style by 5-2.
Likely. Making the positional side of the shot just a little bit more difficult. And attempted to catch the reds just slightly thicker than that. And now
54.
Left himself an awkward one. Middle distance. Stun run through.
55.
Well, no problem. He looks in good shape this afternoon to me, queuing very well.
12.
Just a touch of right hand side on to miss the red 62. By the cushion.
63.
And again, not playing straight onto the black, leaving the angle so he can negotiate the white ball anywhere.
Great start this from Ronnie O'Sullivan, and he's just a red away now from making this opening frame safe.
71.
There it is.
Yes, you wouldn't bet against him knocking in the century. First shot. Not bad, is it?
Well, he was let off the hook last night by Tom Ford, and maybe
79.
The reprieved man syndrome is coming into play. He looks very relaxed out there.
Well, it did start off like this with Tom Ford. He knocked in a big break to win the first frame. Tom Ford duly won the next three.
86. Well, the highest break so far is 142. Now, O'Sullivan still has 51 remaining. 93. Here, so he can beat that. He's going to 144.
94.
Yes, we'll need blacks with the remaining two reds. And there's the century.
It's not a bad way to start, is it? Century break in the opening frame.
Yes, opening shot. Well, no, he had one bad safety shot previous to that, didn't he?
Well, we'll let him off that because he's done the business since. That's his first century of the tournament. It's 15th of the season. He's taking a pink now, as you see. So, a possible 143 on if he takes the black off the last red.
Well, that's interesting.
No, and he didn't pop the red anyway, but a break of 108 is a fine start from Ronnie O'Sullivan. So, he had a struggle last night, but has made a good start this afternoon. Ronnie O'Sullivan takes the opening frame then against Ali Carter. He needs four more for place in the quarterfinals of the Northern Ireland Trophy. Ronnie O'Sullivan to get frame two underway after that fine start to the match. That 108 in the opening frame has given him the lead against Ali Carter. And for those of you who follow the stats, I can tell you that was his 494th century, O'Sullivan. But Stephen Hendry is still over 200 ahead in first place, 708. O'Sullivan is second, and John Higgins in third place on 365. So O'Sullivan not far off the 500 mark now, just six to go.
Well, Ali Carter electing to play safe. But that was a chance at the red.
One.
And he may have wished he'd have taken that red on now.
Eight. Nine.
Well, got too much reaction on the white ball, took it too close to the corner pocket. Intended to come round the two angles. But is it a problem? Is it a problem?
16.
And if he's on the red behind the yellow, well, he isn't. Still has this long red.
16, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Well, that all went wrong, so Ali Carter then comes to the table with a chance to put some points together.
Yes, did have a chance, but was rather straight, and he had to force the white ball out for the black. Trying to pinch a little on the pocket. But it looks like he's got away with it at first glance.
Whoa.
The red past the blue. Ronnie duly knocked it in. Clean as a whistle.
Six. Seven.
Now, will he go into the pack? Open the balls up. And have the red over the left corner. Was there any doubt?
14.
And could elect to go into them again. There is a red just above the black to the right of it. Looks perfect.
22.
Yeah, you have to say already, it's looking like 2-0 after the way he played in the first frame.
Yes, David, you see Ronnie O'Sullivan in this type of form with reds open, and you just don't visualise him missing.
30.
It doesn't look like he's going to miss.
31.
Oh, just didn't get hold of that white ball. Wanted to be straighter on the pink.
37.
And now I'm back in ideal position.
38.
And left that one short. Let's get the other side of the blue. And play to be straighter on this red.
43.
And this is a thin cut back into the left corner.
44.
Made it look easy. So 60 points in front. Brown would be 64, so just one more red. And a colour.
48.
This is superb stuff, isn't it?
Certainly is. Ali Carter is yet to pot a ball in this match. Did have a chance earlier on in the frame,
56.
But missed the initial red, and this has been Ronnie O'Sullivan's response.
And this is why millions of people are hooked to the game when they see it played like this.
64.
And this is looking increasingly like the second century.
65.
On the bounce.
Well, he's had a checkered career as Ronnie O'Sullivan, on and off the table, but nobody would doubt his extraordinary talent.
72. 79.
And just as the angle to stun over for the red. 80. How about that? Everything to perfection.
87. 88.
'Has to play the hard way up for the yellow. Could have played just up the table. Just to make it hard for himself.
100.
There's the century. Two in two frames.
104.
Absolutely.
It's still best of nine in this round, and it's Ali Carter to start. Joe Johnson is alongside me this afternoon, and Joe, well, it was a struggle for Ronnie O'Sullivan last night, but the main thing from his point of view is he's still here.
Yes, I suppose that is the main point of view. As regards Tom Ford, he was very disappointed at missing the blue in the middle pocket, among other balls that he missed along the way, of course, but it was the blue that finally cost him the match, and Ronnie can count himself very fortunate to be playing in this quarter-final. And he's playing a man who, again, is not afraid of Ronnie. Played him a few times. And it was his safety play yesterday that let Ronnie O'Sullivan down, I felt. And once again, his opening safety shot, cannon into a red, then the blue, and he's left an early chance for Ali Carter.
Well, the last of their six meetings was in the China Open last season. It was a close match. It's in the last 16 in Beijing, and O'Sullivan came through 5-4. Ali Carter yet to beat Ronnie O'Sullivan in six meetings, but had a good win in the first round against Nigel Bond, always tough to beat. Carter came through that one 5-3.
Yes, always gives Ronnie a tough game. Well, that was a chance, albeit it wasn't easy. Had to play with side, but he's left Ronnie O'Sullivan with a possible chance into the left middle. Fairly strong to get the right side of the blue, and Ronnie, as always, will want to be freeing that black as soon as possible. And that looks like the ideal opportunity, just to leave the white ball where the red is.
Seven.
How quickly his brain works. Drops into gear straight away.
14.
Yes, there's lots of players that play like this in practice and see the game quickly in practice. But when all the pressure's on, Ronnie still sees it that way. Immediately playing for the correct ball, that gets him onto the black.
We
saw O'Sullivan, of course, a couple of weeks ago in Aberdeen in the final of the Grand Prix. Lost out there to Marco Fu, 9-6. Still looking for his first ranking title since the 2005 Irish Masters. That was in the Republic of Ireland in Dublin. But he made the point last night in his press conference that he has won other tournaments, not least the Masters at Wembley. And he's always the favourite in every 30. Tournament with the bookies.
And there you just got a glimpse of the grip of Ronnie O'Sullivan. Opens his fingers. Just as he delivers the cue. And then a closed grip just as he plays the shot.
38. 39.
's got the cue ball just off straight on the black. He can put the cue ball more or less anywhere he wants, and really Ronnie was spoiled for choice there on which red to play for. Had the choice of four or five. And just over on that slab. Absolutely wonderful stuff.
Wow. 109. 115.
Yes, virtuoso stuff so far from Ronnie O'Sullivan. A break of 108 in the first frame. And a break of 122 in the second frame. So Ali Carter is yet to pot a ball in this match. Ronnie O'Sullivan leads by 2-0. Ronnie O'Sullivan it is to get frame 4 underway. Now leading Ali Carter 2-1. Stephen Hendry lost the opening frame to Sean Murphy. He's lost the second frame as well, so Murphy going well there, 2-0. He leads the 7-time world champion.
A good safety shot, found the right line. Well, Ronnie may have left a possible chance into the back corner pocket or even the right middle.
One.
Nicely played. One. Right in the heart. Just overdone that somewhat.
Six.
It's okay. like to be playing for the red next to the black, to the left of the black. That would really open the game up. Yes, just felt that Ali played for the wrong red, the shot previously. Had he played down for the red to the left of the black, he may have still been going now. So it's just a safety shot.
Brown ball.
I don't think he's played a particularly good one. I think Ronnie can get to this red over the left corner. Pot. Super confident, played for the blue as well. No intention of playing a shot to nothing. And that's the tight bridge. Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Six.
And this time Ronnie can drop in behind the black. Just needed a bit more pace in the white ball. And immediately playing for that red to the left of the black.
40.
And this will open the game up completely for Ronnie O'Sullivan. 50. Really got all of that one. In fact, got all of it too much. Played for the loose red at the left of the pack.
23.
But now in prime position and can play for any red he likes.
Twenty-nine.
Well, O'Sullivan's timing has been immaculate today, and that's hardly surprising because he's just signed a big deal with a Chinese watch company. He was in China last week, undertaking a promotional tour and shooting some adverts. Very lucrative deal, and it just shows A, how popular he is, and B, how popular the game is over in China. That's where he last played, Ali Carter, last season in Beijing. That went the distance, all nine frames. But O'Sullivan clearly has the edge so far today. In fact, he was saying yesterday, O'Sullivan, that he enjoyed going to China so much he was thinking of buying a house there. And bearing in mind the way the circuit is expanding, more and more tournaments possibly cropping up there. There's already two ranking events in China. That may not be a bad idea, because I'll have to do quite a bit of travelling.
53. Where's the red going? Well, it's called getting them ready.
58.
Yes, no sudden movements, please.
Wonder if he'll let the house out when it's not there, David. I'm free most of the season now. Well, that was difficult to get the white ball out, but look at where it's landed. And he'll take that one.
So this black will put him 53 ahead with 51 on. Looking like 3-1.
66.
Could be another century.
67.
He's already had two in the match.
73 74 81 82
Well, after that trip to China, he was saying he didn't have much time to practice, but as you can see, he's playing very well today.
87.
Left-handed on the yellow.
89.
And right-handed on the green. Always helps when you can switch around like that.
92.
Yes, I wonder which hand now. Wonderful to watch.
96.
Yes, this blue now is all it requires for a third century.
101.
There it is.
Well, a great performance this from Ronnie O'Sullivan. Three centuries in the three frames he's won. And he's not even going to bother with the black. 107 was the third of them. And it gives him a 3-1 interval lead over Ali Carter, who now has it all to do. He's going to have to leave the arena for the interval, and he'll be back, and will be back, very sure.
And those three-frame victories have all been with centuries. A 108, a 122, and a 107. Ali had a 50 for his part, which helped him to take frame three. But here we are then at the start of frame five of a possible nine, this for a place in the quarterfinals.